India and Central Asia have a long shared history of cultural and commercial exchange. In recent years, both regions have made efforts to revive their relations, establish geopolitical alliances, and improve connectivity. There are a few projects that have been underway to maintain this cooperation between the two. Let's take a look at them and try to understand their strategic importance. India's relations with Central Asia date back to ancient empires and civilizational linkages. From the Kushana Empire to trade via the Silk Routes and Babur's conquest of India. This historic connection facilitated a rich exchange of ideas, goods and people. Silk Route. It is believed that Faxian, a Chinese Buddhist monk, journeyed to India via the Silk Route. He spent his life translating Buddhist scriptures and documenting the similarities between cultures on the route, India, China, Central Asia. There are several accounts of such historical figures. However, Silk Route trade declined as colonial interest in Central Asia was negligible. Even after India attained independence, the focus remained on its immediate neighbors. However, India maintained diplomatic relations with the Soviet Union and even established a consulate set up in Tashkent in 1987. Following the dissolution of the Soviet Union in 1991, India began to pay greater attention to its extended neighborhood. During this period, former Prime Minister P.V. Narasimha Rao visited the newly formed republics. While this promoted bilateral relations between the two regions, their progress in forming substantial agreements remained slow. It is only in the last decade that India has developed a renewed interest in Central Asia. Governments from both regions have directed policies towards cooperation and initiated infrastructural projects. Pakistan, Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, Turkmenistan, and Tajikistan form the Central Asian republics. Historically, Central Asian republics are resource-rich regions and a significant energy hub of resources like oil and natural gas. While geoeconomics is one of the major driving forces in allying the two, India's involvement in Central Asia can help promote security cooperation. In the past, both regions have been affected by threats like terrorism and extremism. India's complex relations with Pakistan and political instability in Afghanistan add to these complications. Since these issues can place both India and Central Asian republics in positions of vulnerability, cooperative security measures would become mutually beneficial. Moreover, Central Asia offers accessibility for global connectivity and acts as a gateway to the markets of Europe. Major powers like China and Russia have had a head start in realizing these opportunities. Chinese policy has been hegemonic and exploitative. Due to a lack of transparency in infrastructural projects, countries like Kyrgyzstan and Tajikistan have landed in China's debt trap. In contrast, India has adopted a constructive approach in its policies towards Central Asia. By encouraging an exchange of knowledge in education, health, technology and transport. Since there is growing anti-China sentiment in the Central Asian Republic countries, this interest has also received support from them. India's Connect Central Asia policy, launched in 2012, advocated for people-to-people engagement. In 2015, the newly elected Prime Minister Narendra Modi visited all five Central Asian Republic countries, which solidified India's intention to strengthen its relationship with the region. To expand its presence in Central Asia, India has invested in bilateral and multilateral connectivity projects. In 2000, the International North-South Transport Corridor (INSTC) agreement was signed between India, Russia, and Iran. The agreement was ratified in May 2002. The INSTC is a 7,200-kilometer long multimodal transportation network that consists of road, sea, and rail links to enhance connectivity with landlocked Central Asian countries. It would connect Mumbai to St. Petersburg, Russia, via the Iranian port of Bandar Abbas, and even offers to establish connectivity with Europe. Since 2012, the INSTC membership has expanded to include another 10 countries. Another large-scale project that would help connect India with Central Asia is the development of the Chabahar port. In 2016, MOU was signed between Iran, India and Afghanistan. Recently, India has proposed that the port be developed as one part of the INSTC corridor. It is expected that the project would counter China's dominance in the region. In addition to these major projects, India has made efforts to build its diplomatic ties. In 2017, the country became a full member of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization. In an attempt to assist business collaborations, the India Central Asia Business Council was launched in February 2020. The council would serve as a platform to encourage trade initiatives. While the agreement proposed to lay focus on the energy sector, it would also invest in human resources, the agriculture sector, etc. The development of the INSTC stands in opposition to China's Belt and Road Initiative. Announced in 2013, this massive infrastructure project aims to develop two new trade routes and expand Chinese presence globally, from Europe to East Asia. While it might seem like China's attempt to revive the ancient Silk Route, with the BRI, China intends to overtake US as the largest economy in the world. At present, more than 60 countries have signed on to projects that are part of the BRI. In pushing its BRI agenda, China seems to have employed a noticeable pattern in its alliances with low-income countries. Under its hegemonic pursuits, China appears to be leaving behind a series of debt traps with little regard for transparency, human rights, or liberal values. This has been termed debt diplomacy, making Chinese presence in Central Asia a looming threat. Two of the biggest projects under the Belt and Road Initiative are the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor that connects China to Pakistan's Gwadar port and the China-Europe Express Railway. The former is a threat to India's strategic interests. Thus, the International North-South Transport Corridor, INSTC, presents as India's response to the BRI. India's investment in the INSTC and the Chabahar port protects its interests and establishes regional connectivity. Considering the conflicts between India and Pakistan that prevent the former from accessing Central Asia, these agreements appear pretty calculated. However, the Taliban's recent unpredicted takeover of Afghanistan has created trouble for both the Belt and Road Initiative and North-South Transport Corridor. Immediately after the takeover, China had conveyed its intentions to maintain its relations with the Taliban regime. Considering China's foreign policy of not interfering in these internal affairs, it is possible that this shift in power would not affect Chinese ambitions in the region. But the Taliban's rise remains an uncharted territory, and this instability could become a major hindrance for the BRI developments. On the other hand, the Taliban's rule could have adverse consequences for India's INSTC. Under the former government, Afghanistan had been a major stakeholder in the Chabahar port development and, by extension, the INSTC corridor. These projects were expected to improve business channels with Afghanistan. But now, given the uncertainty, India might have to wait patiently for the chaos to settle down. If the Chabahar port was to become a dead investment, it could become a roadblock for the INSTC. In turn, this could affect India's hopes of developing mutually advantageous political and economic relationships with Central Asian Republic states. Ever since the dissolution of the Soviet Union, Central Asia has been recognized as a strategic location that forms a gateway between Asia and Europe. It is rich with energy resources, grants accessibility, and seems valuable from security, geopolitics, and trade perspectives. In recent decades, this region has become the playground for a new great game. Thus, it becomes crucial for India to expand its policies towards Central Asian Republic states and adopt an active role in realizing this potential. India must employ soft diplomacy in a world where powerful states constantly tussle to gain the upper hand. The fact that India shares cultural ties with Central Asia can work to its advantage. Unlike Russia and China, which seek to control through political influence and hegemony, it must take a holistic approach. Eventually, this would expand India's political and economic position beyond its immediate neighborhood and gain global visibility as a regional power. Thank you.